Oh, I guess I should turn that off, huh? Hello, everybody. It's the Poltergeist. I'm back and more the messenger. We're starting off a little bit early in the thing right now because we're playing a video game and it's gonna be crazy. Wow.
Beep.
It's awfully nice of them to respawn all those time shards. It's like, hey, could you hurry it along? I'm all out of time cards. Anything I'm missing in here? Looks like a big ol' no! Can use world map, go back to the ninja village. In front of me was a hungry botanist, were too patient for their own good. Oh. I think I know what you're talking about. In the last episode, we entered the Metroidvania portion of this video's game. Oh, I already got that one. And unlock the ability to travel back and forth through time whenever we want. Well, not whenever we want, but depending on what is... depending on nearby time portals. I can afford time sense, but I really want to get these two. Rejuvenative spirit. Sure, it can pierce two targets. Holy shit, I want that. Oh, man. Okay, but first I'm going to go back to the Tower of Time HQ. Because we got the, in the last episode, we picked up this astral seed. Now to find a flower bed and wait a few centuries. Well, I remember one place where there were some people were trying to grow something, but we can't go through the portal there because, as foretold by mists, this portal shall be open from the other side. So what do you think? Should we go to the band? Should we come at that place from Glacial Peak, or should we come at it from the Howling Grotto? I think I'm gonna go to the Howling Grotto because we really blazed through this area when we first. When we first came here, and where the hell are we? It honestly makes me wonder, like, why they bothered, like, why some of them were already opened. I guess for the same reason some of the music notes are already there. Because, you know, just somebody in the past just did it when they went. Just somebody in the past, some previous messenger just got some work done, so we don't have to do all of it. And that was awful nice of them, you know? It was awful nice of them, you know? You know what they ought to do? You know what they ought to do? Okay, I can't go any further there. Am I back in... yeah, I am back in proper town now. I am just going to try on an array of clothes. You know, become Mike Tyson's agent, ow! Okay. Wait, hang on, I want to land on this thing so I can save my game! Hey! I love how even this version of the song has that sample. I mean, it makes sense that, like, the more advanced version of the song would have the sample. I'm surprised the 8-bit version had it more, honestly. Oh, this part of the game is so nice and relaxing. Which actually reminds me of something else I started playing. Yesterday, after church, we went out and picked up somebody in our, somebody in our city was selling a Super Nintendo. Yeah, believe it or not, they were actually selling a Super Nintendo. So we drove out there and picked it up for $80. It came with only one official controller, one like extra controller that looks really weird. It's like really big, and it has like a bunch of extra buttons, and the L and R buttons are positioned along the L and R buttons are positioned along like along with the A and B buttons. They're like face buttons, which is strange. Ooh, that was close. Ooh, oh, man, I was just a little bit too far away. Yeah, my controller's working fine, you ass clown. Take. Okay, would you stop eating my food? Like, seriously, you gotta be getting full here pretty soon, buddy. Okay, he's gone. I just wanna get the money, man. What was I saying? Yeah, so we got some... yeah, so it works. I hooked it up to a TV we got downstairs that didn't have anything else hooked up to it because I lent my PS2 to a friend of mine who is not allowed to use the internet for, like, a long time, only compounded by the pandemic. But I don't have my PS2 right now. which honestly makes me even more thirsty to do Final Fantasy X for my 400 subscriber special, but I can't! I have to do Ocarina of Time this year! And Star Fox 64, Seraphax Temperatures, except not. Anyway, we could do this. It's like, now if you could finally keep your big mouth shut, you'll see how it's done! Fuck! Oh, dude, I'm stupid. I'm so stupid. You're supposed to grab onto the side of the thing that comes down, and then when it goes up, when it goes up, the other thing comes down, and then you can just grab onto it. Oh my god, I'm so stupid. I'm such a silly goose. Stop eating all my shit, you fucking asshole. You can't eat anymore.
I defy you, greed demon.
Oh, what, he respawned too? Wow. Oh, I'm dead too? Wow. Anyway, yeah, we got Super Mario Kart, we got, this Tasmania Devil game, Tasmania or whatever. Really surprised me. I thought it was gonna be, like, some shitty platform, but it's like a... But it's like, You can pretend you just wanted to show them how I always have random contextual insults when you die. How funny that that wasn't a, that was that that in, that that particular insult wasn't contextual. Can I upgrade this yet? Yes, I can. I want centered mind very much. 350 ring. 250. 250. Oh hey, there you are, Quarble. I love that he has to like when you go in and out of the Tower of Time, he has to like catch up with you from like a random direction. It's like when you use the magic mirror in Terraria and you have a pet like the Zephyrfish who can't teleport. So instead I have a message on Discord. Ooh, there we go. Jeez. I don't care. I got it. But one game we got Draken, which I wasn't even aware Draken had an English translation. My only exposure to the game had been the Game Grumps playing it, Their copy of the game was in Japanese, so I thought it was only in Japanese. So I was quite surprised to see that. When we saw it on the listing that they had Draken, it's like, what? But when I put it up on YouTube, I was all like, what? Yeah. But I started playing it, and man, that game is weirdly relaxing. It's like really slow and hands-off. It's just like this D&D, like, point-and-click adventure. It was really fun. I look forward to playing more of it, even though I'm aware it's not very good. What? Oh, shit, we're in Quillshroom Sharp. We're in Quillshroom Sharp, Sharp, Sharp. Here we are, Poop Pop Pete. Actually, that might be my mom telling me that my eggs are burning. Oh, hey, right here. This is another one of the Easter eggs. Right here in the tree, it's a figure of death holding a pear, just like in the story about Madame Misery trapping death in her pear tree. Oh man, is there like a secret over here? I bet there is. I smell a secret. Ah, there's no secret. What a cockatrice. Oh, man! Okay, no. Okay. Somewhere in this game, there is a room where, like, the stairs are placed perfectly that it's impossible to fill in one square of the map, and it drives me absolutely batty. Wait, is this going to the... This is going to the Boiling Crags. Yeah, or the Searing Crags, yeah. Boom, boom, ding, boom, bing, 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 do, ding, do, bing, do, ding, do. Oh, you know, I was thinking, like, those aren't. I thought the lanterns in that part of Quillshroom Marsh didn't, you know, rung a bell, rung a different bell. Ooh, awesome! We just opened the Searing Crags teleporter. Sweet. Okay, I'm actually going to pause the recording and see what this message is. Give me a second. Yep, that was about the omelet I had on the stove. I thought it would cook a lot slower than that, but I guess it was, I didn't set it as low as I should have. As I should have. Now I have a little while to keep playing before I have to go put the pizza in the oven. Even though it's only 3:13 p.m., I decided, you know what, I want to make pizza now. Because... my sibling is coming back home today. They had a weird operation thingamagoo that I'm not 100% sure of the ramifications of, but it was a... It was gnarly biz. And, actually, I do know what it is, but it is not for your eye or ears, so... Dude, why didn't you do the thing? I guess that was my punishment for getting sassy with my viewers, huh? But the ninja didn't do the thing. How dare he? How dare you dodge the barrel? Stop it! Eee! Okay. Anyway. See, what are we doing now? I was gonna go somewhere, so nothing really I can do in here. Oh, wait, there's a thing I can go over there! I can't go it over here, though, because I need to... need to find a time portal. Ideally, one that I can actually, preferably one that does heart transplants. And not one that just does clothing. Is it possible for me to tahoo? Oh yeah, it's totally possible. Yeah, what the heck, man? Yeah, it's totally possible for me to get over here in the past. Oh, I fell down. Whee! Taking a dump on the figure. Wait, how are those... Dude, what the heck, man? Okay. How are those, I hit those lamps in the future, and they were still, quote-unquote, consumed in the past. How does that work? Whack as shit is what it is. I guess they're, like, illuminated with time crystals or whatever, so it makes sense that they wouldn't, Dude, get off the wall!
Get off the wall, man! I said get off the wall! And I would appreciate it if you would afford me this small luxury!
Ow.
I'm gonna take it.
What's in here? I wanna see what's that thing! What's over here? This is a secret. It's a power seal. Whoa. Don't. Oh, I see. You're just supposed to get through that whole thing. I bet you wish those movie lots were a bit more forgiving.
Man, don't put me all the way back here, bitch, and in the past too, really. I mean, seriously, man. It just seems like such overkill, man. You're going back here, including me in the past, man. I tell you what, dang, I'll lock me up in the sacred realm, man.
Okay, hit the checkpoint again. Jeez. Yeah, you just gotta, like, you know, zip through here, like, ah! You know, like, ah! Shit! Oh, man, that was close. I found him! Alright. Ooh, money! Okay, no money, I guess.
Fine.
I won't complain. I won't grovel. Woo! Oh, baby. Baby. No, I want to stay in the future, ass wagon. I want to kill the green Kappa, which I found out that all the demons in this game are actually called Kappas. Why'd you get your health back? You shouldn't have got your health back. I mean, I guess I understand if an enemy respawns when it goes off screen. That never made much sense. The enemy respawns when it goes off screen. If it's dead, it's not there to go off screen anymore. You know, but... You know. If an enemy dies, and then where the enemy spawns travels off screen... they respawn. Then it makes sense that would extend to surviving enemies getting their health back. That just makes sense. As much as I think that, like, especially in situations like Stop hiccuping! Jeez! Like a Zelda 1, for instance. Doesn't do that. And it's awesome. I mean, it does. Like, enemies get their health back, but it's, like, on a macro scale. What the hell am I even talking about? I guess that's everything here. That was weird wording. Hey, I wonder where the Emerald Golem is. Is he still around? Good question, bro. Did I say that I put the pizza in the oven? No, I didn't put the pizza in the oven. I said it was a... I forget what I haven't said, and it makes it so stupid because it's like... Ugh. Would you finish a thought before you move on to the next one? You sound like a dang fool when you're sitting there like, oh, did I say this? Oh, and then I did, and I'm like, oh well, I'll say it again. Oh man, I didn't know you could grab onto those. That's so cool. We're well on our way to getting that extra upgrade. I'm surprised all was down here. Am I really though? Am I that surprised? I'm not even sure anymore at this point. What are we even doing? We're trying to get back to the... We're trying to go to the Searing Crags. Because as you may have gathered, I am a nonsense judge. What the hell? Okay. Because as you may have gathered, we have to plant the astral seed at Kolos and Susus's camp. That's the only place there is in this world to plant seeds, apparently. We can't just, you know, till some ground with our katana. Ow. Careful. Oh, right here. I think it's another one. It's the axe with the severed hand with the wedding ring on it from the werewolf bride. Oh, wait, what is this? Looks like there used to be a magic artifact here. Maybe if I had been here sooner. Ooh, interesting. Hey, good timing. I want to buy an upgrade. Boy, 17 minutes, man. These are going by fast. I love these Metroidvania episodes. They just go by so fast and it's just so fun. Oh. Jeez, craziest music ever. We can keep going. Wait, what? Is there an up here? Hello. Don't mind if I do. Don't mind if I was not already in the process of doing. Beautiful. That wasn't even... That was easier than some things they made us do in regular Culture Marsh. Not really, but there is that one place. You might remember what I'm talking about. Or you might not. Or it could be bad. Dude. I wanna kill you! What? He just came out and then he went right back in. Oh, great, it's a man! It's a bitch! I love these mushrooms dancing along with the music. I don't think there's a hey there, but it sure feels like there should be a hey there. A hey, you know? I want to go up here this way. Don't feel like
dancing.
Oh god, what LP is that where he starts an episode randomly with that? I think it's a Zelda. Oh, good job, asshole. Yee! Okay. I never noticed the sound these guys make before. Oh my god, those things are so slow. Jeez. Yaw! Oh my gosh, I, the moment I did that yaw, a whole bunch of spit went down my throat. Probably sounded really nahy. Probably not as nahy as me proceeding to reveal it to everybody listening to this video. That's weird. That's a weird thing to say, huh? Listening to this video. Like, you're not supposed to listen to videos, you silly. You're supposed to watch them with your eyeballs. If you listen, it's listening to music or whatever. I don't even know who I'm talking to. Can I get that time sense? I want it. I want that time sense. I want that cake! Time sense! Ayy! Fuck yeah, now we can see on the map where there are time portals. Like, as such as there. 20 minutes! 11 minutes, what the fuck? Okay, bye! Let's get this. I think I am gonna end the episode in a bit here. We're gonna have to wait until next episode to get up to Searing Crest. Man, oh my god, this LP is like, it's gotten so, like, confused ever since we entered Metroidvania mode. Like, I'm not even, like, I've totally lost all focus. There we go. No, I have to get to the top of the Searing Crag in this episode. Like, that's what I said we were gonna do. That's what I said we were gonna do in this video. I can't just not do that. That'd be so dumb beyond the 2D thrust. How far are we from the... Oh my god. You know what? Okay, I'm gonna make it to the Searing Crags, and next episode we will continue our journey to meet back up with Kolos and Susus, and hopefully use their garden. But I am gonna make it to the Searing Crags first. This is what I was thinking about before when I said, "Oh, so it's probably as bad as some of the other things in the original version." Remember when I said that so eloquently? Man, I missed that 8-bit version of this area. It sounds so freaking cool. It's so scary, man. It's Kelly. Wait a second. No! Wait, how could you? Ow! I don't like it, man. Man, I'm kicking ass here, though. Hang on. Oh, that goes down there. I see. Well, let's go head off. Let's head over to the right first. Dude! Okay. Let's head over to the right first. Shit! Okay. What? Oh my god, really? Holy crap! Oh jeez, I just died to a regular enemy! Oh, that's embarrassing, man. Would you get out of here? Jeez. I'm still gonna do this the way I said I was gonna do it. I'm gonna do this the normal way. Now, I need to take detours, man. I need more coinage. I want more dough all the time. Okay, seriously though. Dude. Okay. Ugh. That's one annoying thing is that sometimes you just want to use the wingsuit, but it keeps doing the cloud step, and it's like, I don't want to use the cloud step, man. I want to do the other thing. Okay, this just goes down here. And that's all there is to it. Yeah, there's nothing else. No, I don't want to... Oh, jeez. Okay. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna go over here. Is there a time portal anywhere? Maybe we can make it over there without the time... Maybe we can make it over there even in 8-bit. Besides, this area is hell of a lot less dangerous in 8-bit, like right here. Oh god, I hate these guys. Getting all fa-ha, going all far, throwing them all far like a bitch. Now, let me tell you something. It sure makes it feel amazing to backtrack through these areas, considering how just totally damn... What the hell just happened there? Considering just how... It's just so danceable, you know? Oh, this is this. That's right. Yeah, I think we actually did need to be... Wait. Hang on. There we go. Ah, dude, get out of the way, man! There we go. Hit these things, and then they get rid of the spikes, and then you can make it up here. There you go. And this is just a power seal, but you know what? I don't even care. I got it. That was clumsy, but I got it. Thank God for that resistance, ability. Oh man, I got so much money! There's money over here! Hey, somebody get me! Drop! Okay, jeez. I forgot how to drop for a second. Wait, was I gonna go this way? Yeah, sure, what the hell. Let's keep going this way. I want more money anyway. Oh, so good. Woo! Doom. Man, that was fast. Holy cow. All right, so here's where we met the... Oh, hey, there, here she is. Let's talk to her. You may have won our duel, but my Quillshroom will still try to get you. Okay. Whatever, whatever, lady. I'm gonna stop right here. Actually, can I buy an upgrade? Yes, I can! Yay! Power Sense. I'll buy the rest of the map upgrades before we start saving up for that power fuck. Anyway. Yeah. So that's gonna do it for this episode of The Messenger, sorry we didn't really get anything de facto done here, but next time we're gonna climb the Searing Crags again, exploring secret areas all the while, and hopefully meet back up with Kolos and Seussis at the top, and grow ourselves some tea leaves. Yeah, party central, right? Alright, bye. So you're telling me the point of this adventure was to travel to the end of a swamp and chill with a hot babe? I mean, I can't even fault anyone right here. I mean, this is perfect game design.